Now it's 10:05. I'm in Mandarin Oriental. Yeah, close it. So the pro conference room is on the ground floor. Yeah, you can circumvent all the roadblocks if you have a motorcycle, so you can go here, go there, go everywhere. No problem. This is Mandarin Oriental. Japan weekend joint. Did you say turn left or turn right? No idea. Ah, should be that one there.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Japan conference. Wow, lovely chandelier. And that's the main lobby area, I think. Very nice. A bit late. Never mind. Wanted to refresh myself actually. Still toilet somewhere around here. There's no food unfortunately. Maybe there's some coffee. Who knows? Okay. Okay, started already, right?
No, it's inside, so you can just proceed in.
No problem. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Is it you? Pool.
We've also seen an increase in the number of tourism attraction, tourism appeal in Japan, in Malaysia. So we've seen more Malaysian tourists going to Japan every year. Aligned with that, the Malaysian broadcast companies have also worked together with Japan to create some programs that are based in Japan.
こうした中で我々の狙いは音楽、観光、漫画に関するプロモーションを同時にこのクアラルンプール市内の数カ所の会場で実施しまして、で各イベントの参加者に対してより幅広い日本への関心を喚起することにあります。
With all these considered, especially with the increasing inbound and outbound number of Malaysians and Malaysian interests flowing into Japan, we are having this promotion mainly in the focus of music, tourism and manga in the Kuala Lumpur market. And with this, we hope to further increase the interest of Malaysians in the Japanese market.
連携するイベントとしましては、JETRO とプロミックを中心とした日本のコンテンツビジネスを支援する Jpop Signature & CEO と、それから2番目に日本の漫画の PR とビジネス支援を目的に経済産業省漫画フェスティバル実行委員会が実施する漫画フェスティバル in マレーシア、それから訪日旅行の促進を図るため観光庁 JNTO が実施するジャパントラベルフェア2016年です。
So if you notice that up there as well, the events that are being held in collaboration with this particular corporation, first and foremost, JETRO together with PROMIC have brought together the Jpop Signature, which is a music-oriented event, followed by the Manga Festival in Malaysia, which is an event that is more focused on introducing and exploring the appeal of manga in the Malaysian community. And lastly, but definitely not least, this might take a short while, but we would like to introduce Jpop Signature to all of you.
JETRO がプロミックと共催で実施する J-POP Signature in KL では、音楽ビジネス関係者やイベント参加者に向け、多様性に富んだ日本音楽の魅力を発信します。
JETRO and PROMIC are working together in order to organize the J-POP Signature in KL, which is directed to not only individuals who are interested in music, but those in the music industry in Malaysia. It is designed to sort of display and exhibit the appeal of Japanese music to the public.
In Malaysia, there are Japanese music needs for anime 好きの若者や anime を聞くために日本語を学ぶ学生さんなどに支えられると言われています。
In Malaysia, because there is a great amount of interest, especially among the young people in anime and Anison, as well as you know, developing an interest in the Japanese language because of anime, it is designed, this particular event is designed in such a way to sort of introduce this to that particular population. And it could be said that Japanese music have supported the development and interest of the Malaysian population in anime and in the Japanese language.
実際、日本のアニメはかなり古い作品から新しい作品まで、様々なテレビ局、テレビ番組で放映されて、衛星放送で日本のアニメ専門チャンネルも視聴されているようです。Well,
in reality, we broadcast not only the older animes, all the way up to the more recent works on Malaysian television. And on top of that, we also have subscribe to TV channels which show weekly anime.
こうした背景を踏まえて、本日夕方に行われるショーケースライブでは、海外での活動拡大を目指すアーティストが出演し、アニメソングを中心としてリアルタイムの日本の若者音楽の楽しみ方を提案させていただきます。With
this as the basis, they have organized a showcase live later tonight. And this would feature artists in Japan with a focus on anime songs. And these artists are interested in furthering their careers and activities abroad in Malaysia. And we hope that through this, Malaysian can also be able to enjoy Japanese music.
J-pop Signature in KL の 出演 artist は 日本の漫画の PR 等目的、それを実際に体験して楽しんでいただくとか、そういうことが日本のコンテンツの拡大につながっていくと思います。すいません、長くなりましたが、私からは以上です。
For all of you, we'd also like to let you know that the showcase live will be taking place in Zouk later this evening.
You're still talking inside there, and celebrities are there, four of them. And there seems to be something to eat, which is good. But now I want to find a toilet actually. Good that there's some food. I need some coffee actually. There's a toilet. The toilet is very convenient. It's only next to the pro conference room. Pro conference is a bit small. Oh, nice artwork. Grab a lot of tissue paper. Wow, this is like automatic soap dispenser. Oh, very nice. I haven't been in Mandarin Oriental in a long, long time. Very nice.
Together with strategies from Co Japan, we are actually working with this particular strategy in mind. I apologize if it sounds confusing, so let me rephrase that. We are actually currently working with Co Japan, and as part of the efforts to further introduce Japanese industry and economy in Malaysia.
Malaysia has been the case of the story of manga, anime, game, manga, game, and other contents in the Malaysian.
We hope to introduce to Malaysia the appeal and the world of manga, anime, games, music, as well as movies, all various sort of contents, all Japanese. And we hope to further connect all Malaysians to such works. During the manga festival yesterday, it seems that a lot of people enjoyed themselves, so they're very happy for that. With this manga festival as the beginning of it, we hope that more and more Malaysians will, you know, fall in love with Japanese culture and be able to accept Japanese culture. And we expect to see greater interest in all aspects of our Japanese culture and products in the future.
So we can have a photo of all the organizers of the events. From the left, we have Ms. Fuki, Mr. Mao, Mr. Oki Kosuke, and the special unit, Izawa, Mikako, and Nakano Saima.
それでは皆様より順に一言ずつ頂戴をいたします。We would like to
hear a word from each of them.
まず、フキ様、それからキーボードのマオ様より一言ご挨拶をお願いします。So,
a word from Ms. Fuki and her keyboardist.
はい、日本のアニメソング、ゲームソングシンガーのフキと言います。キーボードのマオ君、彼に作曲してもらった曲を歌って、日本で活動しています。
My name is Fuki and I am a anime and game song singer in Japan. This is the keyboardist Mao and he composes the music which we will be singing.
日本のアニメ、ゲーム、漫画の文化をこうしてマレーシアで皆さんに歌う形で披露できることをすごく嬉しく思っております。よろしくお願いします。
We are very honored and very pleased to be able to spread the influence and culture of Japan through singing songs which are related to anime and games in Japan.
フキのキーボードの演奏や作曲をしているマオと言います。マレーシアは初めて来ました。この後のライブもとても楽しみにしています。よろしくお願いします。
My name is Mao and I am the keyboardist for Fuki. And I'm also in charge of composing the songs which she performs. This is my first time in Malaysia and I'm looking forward to the live later.
Selamat petang. Nama saya Kosuke Oki. Panggil saya Ko. Saya gembira. Saya sangat gembira. Jumpa kamu.
Okay. I don't think I need to translate that, but shall I? Okay, very briefly.
なんて言ったんですか?
じゃあ日本人のためにちょっと紹介いたしますので、確かに言っておりましたのが、私の名前は大木浩介です。日本のパフォーマー。
でやってハンドルはこうですって言ってそのあとは皆さんとお会えてとても嬉しいですという形で
拍手してますねこれは
すごいですねバーサム練習
すごい、じゃあ続きまして伊沢美香子&中野サイマ様、よろしくお願いいたします
ハローナモサイマあナモサイヤ伊沢美香子日本のアニメ文化でマレーシアの皆さんとつながれることをとっても嬉しく思っています今日は楽しみたいと思いますよろしくお願いします
My name is, Izawa Mikako and I am a, also a performer from Japan. I'm very pleased to be able to spread this Japanese culture and further interest in Japanese anime to all Malaysians.
では中野様、お願いします。
はい、はじめまして、中野サイマです。私たち二人は日本で声優をやっております。こうやってマレーシアで二人で歌えることを皆様と音楽で一つになれることが今から楽しみです。よろしくお願いします。
All right. My name is Nakano, Nakano Saima. And as a unit, both of us are actually voice actresses in Japan. To be able to come and perform as a unit to all Malaysians, we are really, really looking forward to be able to perform in front of you and be one with all the audience later. We're very happy to be here.
それではまたアーティストの皆さんの写真撮影のお時間を取りたいと思いますのでカメラの皆様は前の方にお集まりください。
So we will have another photo session with the artists. Can we have all the cameramen and ladies, of course, prepare in the front?
ではアーティストの皆様は適宜ポーズなどを取っていただいて。
All right, are the cameras ready?
それでは主催者もちょっと中に参加をさせていただいて一緒に写真を撮っていただきたいと思います。
We would also like to invite the organizers to be up on the stage for a photo session together.後ろの方を少し左に移してお願いいたします。センターの。
にこやかに。 調ございますか?
Are you okay? Again?
はい、じゃあよろしければ、これでフォトセッションを終了させていただきます。ご登壇の皆様、下の方にします。それでは皆様、本日はお忙しい中、ジャパンウィークエンド、合同記者会見にお集まりいただき、誠にありがとうございました。
Alright, thank you for your attendance to the Japan Weekend Joint Press Conference.
これにて終了となりますので、個別インタビュー以外の方はご退出をお願いいたします。
We would like to end it here. For those of you who are not part of the interviews later, we would like to request that you leave the hall. Thank you very much.
どうもありがとうございました。
Thank you.
の外の方に、軽食がございますので、外で、お待ちをいただきます。
We would like to tell you that there are actually some refreshments outside. Please help yourself to the refreshments, and we will inform you when the interview sessions are going to begin later.
個別のご予定をセットしている皆様については、後ほどお呼びいたしますので、外の、ホールでお待ちください。
We are going to set up the room in a little bit for the individual interviews later, so please help yourself to the refreshments outside.
See, Mandarin Oriental has some breakfast right here before it's all gone. Let's see here. We have popiah, fried popiah here. Or spring rolls.
Hey, hi,
with a sweet chili sauce. Mini croissants. Two types of what, Danish pastries. Mandarin Oriental cookies, fruits and stuff, and of course yogurt. Yogurt very important. First off, we have to start with coffee. Needs coffee, orange juice, coffee. It's all the same. Wow, the cups are really huge. That's good.It's not the same as the one in the British High Commission. The British High Commission is more of an English tinge to it. That means small cups. Coffee is not complete without sugar. awesome with the sauce because it's not that salty, the popiah. Of course, it's made of turnips. Better with the sauce. It's sweet and chili like sauce. Successful croissant is buttery and slightly salty. It's puffy. Can taste the butter. Good. It's not salty. I don't think it needs to be salty. It's nice by itself. Although it's not warm, but it's quite tasty. Very nice. Very nice indeed. Very good. My saliva is breaking down the flour into sugar, so I'm tasting the slight tinge of sweetness in the croissant. Excellent. Very nice. I don't even know whether I'm in with the interview process or not. No idea. So, very unfortunate that this press conference happens on a Saturday while the red shirts and the yellow shirts are going to battle it out in KL. So there were a lot of road closures here and there and everywhere, even in the center of which we are in now. KLCC is just next door. Here's the Mandarin Oriental Hotel. It's going to be a lot of road closures. So I'm going to like stay here for a while, do a review of the manga festival at the second floor of ICTN KLCC, go there and take a look. And maybe if I have the time, I mean, the Zouk area, which is a disco building in the embassy area of Kuala Lumpur, which is on the east side of Jalan. I'm not sure what Jalan it is, what road. So that's at 5:30, so we'll be there at 5:30 for the concert. So there will be a lot of time to burn, to while away. And maybe a walk west of this city center to go to those areas where there's like a lot of red shirts and yellow shirts are congregating. Maybe you'll be able to capture some violence. If I wasn't here, I would be there covering that walking of yellow shirts. Red shirts, I'm not sure what's happening at all. Wow, this coffee is strong. It's pretty good. Definitely much better than the British High Commission coffee. This is strong stuff. Feeling like a champion already. The caffeine is like making me strong. I'm gonna grab a fag. I don't know whether I'm gonna eat some more or not. I think I wanna eat some more. The croissant is pretty good. So we've tasted the savory stuff, the meaty type of stuff. Now we're going for some sweet and savory. So this is two of the pastries. There are another two more. So this one is, if you watch the British Bake Off, you know that flour, you need to like do a twist in here and there and make it into a knot. And there's some white sprinkling of sugar. I know you're not supposed to eat it like this with the fork. You're supposed to grab it. I don't want to dirty my fingers and go into the toilet again. You see, this thing is like, it might seem like a lot of sugar, right? Since there's a lot of icing. Is it called icing? Icing sugar on top. But it's not sweet at all. It's strange. I mean, it's slightly sweet, but not really that sweet. That's pretty good. Nice. Maybe some chili sauce and sweet chili sauce on it might make it taste weird. But never mind. There's still some remnants of some chili sauce around here. So this part of Mandarin Oriental, which is on the, I'm not sure which east or west side, there are three rooms, small rooms. One is the one in is in the pearl room, and there's another one here, the opal room, and there's a jade room there. So far, there are two more. Okay. So it's a jam in the middle. There's a lot of jam and kale nowadays. I would say the pastry that I ate just now is almost similar to the one in the mini croissant. Very puffy, lots of layers. For this Mandarin Oriental, you go into the KLCC, it's 1 ringgit. Here there's a parking for the staff. Next to the parking for the motorcycles are an area for the staff to smoke. It's been a long time since I came here. Last time I came here was maybe 10 years ago, maybe in 2002, 2001. I was a pest control operator. I think I did this place as well. So I know the place kind of well, because when you start as a pest control operator, you have to go down level and tell them that you are pest control, tell them that they let you in and spray the kitchen. Kitchen is normally in the depths of the hotel, and cockroaches are not biased. If it's a posh hotel, it doesn't mean that there are no cockroaches, especially the German cockroaches. The jam is cold, not sweet, slightly sweet, but not really sweet. Pretty nice. Pastry, of course, is the same. There's a lot of layers, almost like the croissant. Nice. Just like shop. So I'm not part of the interview, so might as well go. Now it's about 11:30 a.m. Ate my pastries and that's good enough. So time to chop chop. If I go there, I'll actually just say hi to to the captain first. Captain?
Hello.
Hiya, how are you? fine, fine.
Okay, okay. Is that still running?
Yeah, still running.
Oh man, okay, cool. Post event.
You mind? You mind?
Yeah, sure, it's okay.
Well, like, so thanks a lot. Thanks a lot for your website, like Cosplay Fun Malaysia, right?
Oh, cool.
For the past 2 years, I've been using it just to see the schedules and stuff. It's very useful.
Thank you, cool. Thank you for your support. Mm.
So how was this event?
Really exciting because like I had a little video log and because at the Yuri no Mizu's event, the voice acting event, then like, I heard got manga festival, got mangaka coming down to give autograph session, how come we don't know about it? So then later, like, after all the research, going here, going there, going to Instagram, finding out, going on the website, you know, Google.
You had to actually do all this research yourself.
To find out what, and then after piecing together, it's more than just one thing that is Japan Weekend. It's all under Japan Weekend, which is this press conference is unveiling all about. So, and then after that, I thought maybe people are very interested in the manga. I mean, mangaka coming down, you know, current artists. They're doing manga in Japan.
Four of them,
four of them, and actually signing autograph,
Are you going there?
Wow, I don't think I'll be able to make it after this. I gotta go home and look after the kids.
What about the concert for tonight?
Yeah, that one also, macam it's my shift later afternoon and evening shift to look after the kids, you know. So really unfortunate, but you know, hopefully this is the beginning of
more Japanese stuff.
Or even Japan Weekend every year, you know, can be looking forward to that. That'll be cool,
But there was a Jalan-Jalan Japan in one city.
Yeah, I heard about it. There's a store, right? It just opened.
Yeah, I think it's only for like 3 days. I'm not sure. It's
quite
cheap.
I thought it's actually a shop. Oh, it's like a bazaar, is it, or something?
The stuff that Japanese people don't want, they end up here,
Wow. Yeah, I saw some. You know, when you have friends, right, of the same interest, they pick up some old retro toys. You know,
it's cheaper.
Okay, that one is calling me to go there. But I actually thought it's a shop, You know, like a Daiso or
No, I think it's only for a while. I'm not sure actually. It's quite cheap. You buy Ultraman, it's like 6 ringgit.
Yeah, I know, right?
Like, 6 ringgit instead of 30 ringgit outside retail.
So clothes and shoes and I don't know whether it's love or pre-loved or bundle. You know, I don't know what's all that about, but it just looks interesting enough for me. Go check it out.
Okay.
At least that one can bring the kids, right?
So. While it still lasts, I think a lot of people are really taken.
I know, right? There's much love for Japan in Malaysia.
Okay.
Our folks here.
So thank you very much, Captain.
You're welcome. It's a goal, last time I saw you, it's
like, what? You know me? What the fuck?
Yeah.
How come? Because of my face.
Also, recently you commented on the Facebook page as well. But I've seen you before, like any mangaki, and that was like 2 years ago.
How come I never seen you? Huh? This is the first time I'm seeing you.
Ninja. Oh, really? Really? No, I've seen you before, but any events?
2014 STGCC, I was there.
2014, yes, I was there as well. Wait, 14? No, I was there. 2014 I was there.
Okay.
I was there also.
This year did you go?
I didn't go this year. Couldn't make it.
I think it's almost the same old thing.
But that's why for me, as long as American artists, they keep rotating and changing, that's pretty cool.
You like the comics, the American comics?
Yeah, that's right. I grew up reading this kind of stuff when I was young. So it's kind of still attached, and then now with all the Marvel movies and all
it's getting a bit boring already, the Marvel movies.
There are a lot of them. The recent one, Doctor Strange, you can see they're trying to
IMAX,
diversify and all.
You should watch it.
You
watch it?
Actually, I watched it in IMAX. I watched it in normal. And yesterday, I just watched it again.
So it's very entertaining.
And it's opening up another realm. And it's a bit fresh also, actually. I found it fresh compared to the other heroes and all.
I thought it was a lot of critics have said that it's the same old thing because at the end, there's a what's happening? Mm-hmm. Destruction of something, then they turn back time or something like it's magic. So it's magic.
This time they're definitely introducing magic.
No consequences to everything, retcon stuff here and there. So it's
Like the other guy, the Mordo keeps saying in the movie, there's no, you pretend you're doing like there's no consequence. So I'm very sure maybe they're hinting a lot of that, and then later maybe Doctor Strange 2, they'll say what is the consequence of doing that the last time. It makes for more storytelling.
So you, I mean, how did you actually come about with this website, the Cosplay Fund? Is it because of cosplay?
Yeah, initially it was started because I wanted to promote cosplay in a positive way, and also help get it more exposure, more positive exposure. This was like 2010. Decided to start it, and then since then, like, oh my goodness, every year, boom, you know, it's multiplying. And
oh yeah, I think there are too many events. It's like very saturated already.
Now there's a lot of events, and that's why I also feel like okay lah, maybe
same
don't have to focus so much on cosplay anymore lah. Especially cosplay events, because every single weekend there's like 2-3
the
cosplay competitions or cosplay centric events, you know.
The shopping complexes are into the game, so they
have it. Correct, yes, that's right. And they also knowing that if we have it, you know, we can just get people to come, or, you know, young people to come. And that's kind of like quite stereotype and straightforward. Like that's
that's more like a business already, a commercializer.
Definitely.
Which one is your favorite cosplay event?
Favorite cosplay event?
Besides Comic Fiesta. Oh, they're having it in PWTC this year. Not in KLCC or here, Convention Center.
In the mines. Not even, last year they had it in the mines. And favorite comic cosplay event?
Wait, how was it?
I don't really have.
Did you go to the mines?
I went to the mines, but not for Comic Fiesta though.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, last year the Naruto Live Spectacle was there. That was good.
Okay.
Did you hear about that one?
No. Only know about this in the Budaya Center. That
I think it's going to be a better venue though. Istana Budaya for the live spectacle, musical, or even a theatrical play.
Okay. So besides cosplay, right? What else are you interested in?
Games, comics. Like I mentioned earlier, I'm a big fan of Marvel, DC, kind of Western comic stuff. And I also play games, you know, actually with the little time I have, like, you know, once or twice a month.
Which which Marvel character that you wish they would turn into a movie?
Actually, they already did. Captain America is my favorite, so
Captain America.
That's my big favorite, yeah. And then, what else is there? Basically, yeah, Captain America is... I grew up reading Captain America.
Okay.
In the 80s, I read in comics and really enjoy Steve Rogers as Captain America.
Is there going to be a future Captain America 3? The one we had was Civil War, basically.
Yeah, Civil War, I just know that for a fact that Steve Rogers will be there and he will no longer be Captain America, that's quite sure. Steve Rogers will be there, but somebody else will become Captain America.
Is it a black guy?
The black guy in the comics is the current Captain America, which is the Falcon, Sam Wilson. And before that in the comics, it was actually Bucky carrying the mantle of Captain America, while Steve Rogers was the super soldier, they call him. And he was wearing this blue uniform with the logo on it. Yeah.
Is the Red Skull still alive?
They haven't killed him off.
Oh, really?
In the movie universe, they haven't killed him off. Transported to another dimension.
Oh, the comic. He died a long time ago.
In the comic, he dies, then he comes back again.
Because of the Marvel events. Yes. What do you think about the Marvel events? Every year, they kind of like retcon everything, Infinity Wars or whatever. It's just kind of like magic, it just F things up. people die, then they come back.
They come back again. That's
another
right.
dimension. It's just...
They have to have something to write about. That's why I think there's always a lot of reboots and rebirth and new rewrites and all. So, well, I guess it's the quality of the story, you know, whether you like it or you don't like it. Now Marvel is into exploring the same character but a different gender. You know, Thor is a female. You know, the new Iron Man is a girl also.
Yeah, I did not know that the power of the Thor is actually in the helmet. Is it helmet type of power? The Thor power?
It's actually question.
I thought it was a hammer.
Basically, it was a hammer and it was the son of Odin, so that's where his power and strength came from already. the weapon was the hammer was a complimentary, you know, weapon for him, forged by the father just to,
okay,
for him to.
So I'm surprised that you know of me. So thank you very much. This is the first time I'm seeing you, and you saw me somewhere else.
Oh really? Yeah. No, but I've seen you at least a few times before.
Yeah. Always alone. Thank you very much, Mr. Captain.
Alan. Yeah.
Alan.
Yeah.
Known as the captain.
Yeah.
Okay. Thank you very much for this interview.
You're welcome.
So this is the side of the Mandarin Oriental, and of course I'm very familiar with the KLCC conference hall there. That's where the park is, and this is Mandarin Oriental. So how do I actually go to the front of the KLCC so I can walk to the place where they're having that walk of yellow shirts and maybe some red shirts? Will it turn violent? No idea. Ah, shit. How do you actually get there? Where is it? Huh? Where is the KL Tower? I mean, the Petronas should be around there. Ooh, very nice. Mandarin Oriental. The front facade is there. So, it's strange. Can't you go through there? So, KLCC, where to? No idea.